I'm John Mather. I'm the Senior Project Scientist for the James Webb Space Telescope. I work at NASA Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland. And I've been doing this for a long time, since 1995. Before that, I was the Project Scientist for the Cosmic Background Explorer satellite, which measured the Big Bang and earned a Nobel Prize. The Webb Telescope idea started off in 1989 with a conference here at the Space Telescope Science Institute, thinking about what should we do next after the Hubble, which had not even been launched yet. In 1995, a committee was operating to define what should that next great telescope be, and they wrote a beautiful little book called HST and Beyond. Around then, I was called from NASA headquarters to invite me to join the project. So it wasn't really my idea originally, but I did have a lot of influence over how it went. So I met immediately with engineers and managers to think, how could we do this project? What did it need that it didn't have? All the technologies that we needed to invent. And so I worked with study teams and then project managers since 1995. So what did we have to do? First, decide what to do. Translate the scientific request in the little book into requirements on an engineering project. How big is the telescope? How cold is the project telescope? Where are we going to put it? In outer space, of course, but where in outer space? Could it possibly be orbiting the Earth, where we could get at it and surface it? No, it can't be there for various technical reasons. Need to push it farther out, so it's a million miles away from Earth, orbiting a place called the Lagrange Point 2. The initial phase ran through 2002, where we finished up all the technology development, finished all the inventions, and we chose the contractors. We chose the science team members, and we chose the contractor, which was TRW. They were purchased by Northrop Grumman, so that they're now part of this giant aerospace company. Northrop Grumman actually built the spacecraft, and they were responsible for the partnership with the companies that built the telescope. NASA Goddard organized building the instrument package, and we received instruments from Europe and Canada and the United States. We put them all together and tested them at Goddard. We got them down to Houston, Texas for their final test in a giant vacuum tank there during Hurricane Harvey. From there, we shipped everything to California, and the telescope part was attached to the observatory, the hardware that includes the rocket jets and the solar panels and the giant umbrella that we call a sunshade. And that took a much longer time than people thought, because of course there are always a few little mistakes you find and you have to back up and fix them. We finally got to launch on December 25th, 2021 from French Guiana. French Guiana because the European rocket, it's French rocket, it's launched from that spot because it's a good spot for rockets. And so we were very fortunate they were able to launch us on that special morning of Christmas morning and get us up into space with a perfect orbit. And so we immediately then started commissioning the observatory, which means test everything and set it up. So that took 6 months. So by July of 2022, we were taking scientific observations, and the first scientific announcements were made on July 11th with an announcement from President Biden showing, here is our first picture. Well, the biggest challenge for me is actually not really for me. The biggest challenge for us as a project is that the team is immense. When we count up all of the people that worked with us over the years, it's about 20,000 scientists, engineers, technicians, managers, bookkeepers, accountants, everything that it takes to make a giant project go. So organizing and managing that was not actually my job. That was the project managers to do, and they did it beautifully. So I look at what they do, I participate in what they do, and I think it's magic. So what telescope do we want to build next? The National Academy of Sciences reviewed the four candidates that were presented to them for great space telescopes. One would observe X-rays, which we can't do from the ground because the atmosphere is opaque. One would observe far infrared, much longer wavelengths than what the Webb telescope can see. Can't do that from the ground either. And one would be a ultraviolet, visible, and near-infrared telescope, similar to Hubble, only much bigger and more powerful. And that was the one that was chosen as first priority by the National Academy's report. And they said, please build us one that is so capable that it could observe an Earth-like planet orbiting a Sun-like star, and get a separate image, a separate little dot, and say, now we can see the light from that planet. And why that? Because here on Earth is the only place we know where there's life in the universe. Are we alone? Well, probably not, but how would we know? So look for signs of life on another planet that might be like home. So look for one like that. That's a really, really hard project. But we know from having built the Webb telescope and made it work that we know how to build a giant project. And we know how to negotiate international partnerships. We know how to negotiate contracts with giant aerospace companies. We know how to find the design and the parts. So if we want to do it, we can do it. One of the things that I love about working on astronomy is that we get to think about our own origins. Where did we come from? How did the expanding universe produce stars and galaxies that get recycled into dust clouds that turn into new generations of stars and planets? And then how did they make us? So we get to look elsewhere for clues about our own history. So that's what fascinates me. I'd like to know, are we alone in the universe?